Hello, I'm Dr. Tamala Kelly. Today I want to talk to you about being an image bearer and how being an image bearer can actually be a way to address, to engage with racial inequality. Let's go to Genesis chapter 1. Let's go to Genesis 1:27. For God created humankind in his image, in the image of God, he created them, made them male and female. He created them. So what does it mean to be in the image of God, the imago Dei? I like what N.T. Wright says about image of God and what that means, because there's a lot of a theology about what it means to be an image bearer or to be in the image of God. There are a lot of books that have been written about this topic that is that I couldn't even begin to exhaust. However, N.T. Wright says it this way, that to be an image bearer is to be a mirror, and to be a mirror that is reflecting God's love, that is reflecting God's care, that is reflecting God's strength, that is reflecting God's justice to the world, through us, through humanity, to the world. Image bearers. What does it mean to be an image bearer? And that is important, because as we're dealing with so much racial injustice and racism, the church, what is the church's role in engaging? Well, we need to be the church, the people of God that bear the image of God. What does that look like? That we are reflecting God's care for the others, God's care for the outcasts, God's care for those that are oppressed, God's care and concern and desire to bring liberality to all those who are oppressed. So reflecting that image as a church, what does that look like? How should we engage? I think it at least answers the question if we should engage, because believe it or not, there's a lot of question. Should we even engage this? Should we even engage the racial injustices that are going on here in America? I want to say that to answer that question would be to answer, what is it? What does it mean to be an image bearer? What does it mean? Because if we are true image bearers of God, then it would be us reflecting God's will upon the earth, God's way upon the earth, God's kingdom upon the earth. We're reflecting that. We're reflecting that in God's care for humanity. So I think that if we're wrestling as pastors or as leaders, if we should engage in the racial inequalities that are happening in the world against brown people, against black people right now, then I think that we could look to this idea of what does it mean to be the imago Dei, the mago Dei rather. What does that mean? What does that look like for us? Okay, and I want to just even encourage us to know that Jesus was always on the side of the oppressed. He was always on the side of the outcast. He was always on the side of the others. So if we are to reflect him, it's not about our political party, but it is about the reflection of God. How are we reflecting God? How are we reflecting God concerning racial injustice?